Hey y'all, and welcome to Magic and Probability. My name is Martin Malelu, and I am a librarian with LA County Library. Today, I'm gonna show you a few card tricks, and we're going to talk about the probability that these cards would actually reveal themselves if I didn't use sleight of hand tricks to make them appear. But first, we're going to talk about a few magicians who may inspire you to begin a magic career of your own. I want to highlight some magicians from underrepresented demographics. Magic historically has been dominated by men. While most of us are familiar with Houdini, David Copperfield, and Chris Angel, we might not know who Faye Presto, Dorothy Dietrich, and Magic Babe Ning are. Faye Presto is a trans woman who is credited with popularizing close-up magic. Dorothy Dietrich is an escape artist and the only woman to ever catch a bullet in between her teeth. And Magic Babe Ning is an incredible illusionist as well as a Singapore Literature Prize nominated author, publishing under her real name, Ning Kai. So I'm not gonna show you how I do these magic tricks, but I do wanna let you know that if you are interested in learning how to do some magic tricks, we have some books available through our catalog and I'm showing you here how to access them. Feel free to put them on hold and pick them up via our sidewalk service at your local library. All right, so let's get into some magic. As a disclaimer, I am by no means a professional magician. I have learned these tricks only recently, and I hope that you also, from this video, kind of find some interest in learning some magic tricks that you can do as a beginner as well. All right, so I just pulled these out of the box right here, and I'm gonna pull out these jokers and things, right? All right, so just have this deck of cards right here. And the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to pull two cards out of this deck, all right? So I have two cats and their names are Boris and Lugosi. And I am going to pull cards that are their ages, all right? Cause I love them so much. All right, so they are 6 and 9 years old. So I've pulled the 6 and the 9 right here, all right? So for this trick, I'm gonna estimate a third of the way up and then another third of the way up. So I'm gonna put one card in a third of the way up and then another card in two thirds of the way up, all right? So I'm gonna go ahead and do that real quick. And then I'm going to, or you're gonna see if I can actually make this happen. So we're gonna see if I can get those two cards that I put in this deck to come out. All right, we're gonna count to three, ready? 1, 2, 3. Did I do it? Oh, we did it. All right, so we got the 6 and the 9 back. All right, so we know that there's 52 cards in a standard deck of cards, which we have right here. So we wanna know the probability that we're gonna pull this particular 6 and this particular 9 out of the deck. While there's only one of these 6s and one of these 9s, we know we have a 1 in 52 chance of pulling this 6, but then when we go to pull this 9 out, there's only 51 cards in this deck, so we have a 1 in 51 chance of pulling this card out of the deck, all right? So to find the probability of getting both of these cards out of this deck, we're gonna multiply these two numbers together, all right? So we just gotta multiply them together, and I did that math, and it comes out to 0.003770739. That's a pretty slim chance of being able to pull both this 6 and this 9 out of this deck. If you wanna see that as a fraction, it is 3770739 over a 1 followed by 10 zeros. That's pretty slim. I don't think we could have done it without some sleight of hand. All right, y'all, so now I'm gonna do a pretty basic trick. It's called the 21 card trick. It might also be called the 11th card trick. So we need 21 cards. So we have 52 right here. We need to count out 21. All All right, so we have our 21 cards here. We're going to pick one at random. Which one do I like the best? It doesn't really matter. I like this ace. This ace kind of stands out. So we have the Ace of Spades right here. So that's going to be our card. It doesn't matter at all which card you pick because we're going to mix them up. So I have no idea where that ace is now. Okay, so now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to count out three piles of seven cards. And since I have 21 cards, it should make three even piles. All right, so I'm going to do this. All right, so you see our card right here, this ace right here, it's in this pile. So we're gonna go ahead and clean this up. And you know, we're gonna do it all over again, all right? So we're gonna put out three piles of seven cards each. All right, you see our card right here, this little ace right here. So let's go ahead and clean this one up again. And once more, we are going to lay out those three piles of seven cards each. All right, so we see our ace right here. We're gonna clean it up once more. And now our ace is going to be the 11th card in this deck, I bet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Moment of truth. All right, there it is. So you can do this one pretty simply. You can, if we didn't pick our own card, it turns out to be pretty impressive when you can find someone else's card and you know it's gonna be the 11th card every time. So yeah, go ahead and look that one up. It's pretty fun. All right, so let's talk about the odds that we would choose this ace out of this stack of 21, all right? So for this one, we have a 1 in 21 odd of pulling this ace out of this deck of 21 cards. So that is a 0.04. As a decimal, that's what that looks like, 0.048. All right, so, well, it isn't completely improbable that you might pull this ace out. The odds are stacked against you still, but you still might manage to randomly choose the right card if you were to draw a random card from this deck. So let's compare that to the trick that we did earlier, all right? So with that one, we have a much different probability. So we have 3,770,739 over 10 billion. All right, and those odds are much, much slimmer, as you can see, based on the number of digits in each of these percentages. Thank you all for joining me today. I hope that you feel like you learned something. I hope that you feel inspired to do some magic of your own. And remember, the less and less likely something is to happen, the more and more impressive it is when you can make it happen. So click the link in the description to check out some resources we have available. And don't forget to subscribe to stay updated on all of the virtual programming we have to offer. Bye for now.